Hello. Yeah, so hi everyone, this is my first time here at Hackware. So as introduced, I work right across the street at 3 Franklin, and so I'm into working as an engineer in a startup which is into cognitive media solutions. So be it surveillance or be it fashion attributes, everything today uses artificial intelligence, and to the core of it, it uses deep learning. So I participated in Red Hat Open Innovation Labs Hackathon 2017, and these were the problem statements, like five of them, so you can just check it out from the paper if you want. We chose to solve a problem statement which was crowd management in common spaces, and we had to do to collect the parameters like number of footfalls, heat maps and feedbacks from the visitors. So suppose just assume that you are in an you are in some MRT station and you want to calculate the footfall. So there are various ways to do it. One is using sensors, and other is using say camera, for instance. So we went with the camera based solutions because we wanted to leverage the computing power of Raspberry Pi to the fullest. And not only that, it was not only a computer vision based solution, we wanted to integrate it with the cutting edge artificial intelligence which sits on Amazon EC2 instance, because Raspberry Pi doesn't have a GPU and we require high computation for artificial intelligence. So we linked our Raspberry Pi to the Amazon EC2 cloud to give the first real distributed artificial intelligence solution. So this was a problem statement basically. So we had to do number of footfalls, heat maps, and so for feedback there was nothing specified, but we'll see how we did it. So the underlying theory of footfall is we had to detect the ups and the downs, people moving in, people moving out, using, for now we use computer vision. And how did we do it? I'll just demo it for you. So I'll just, so for example, this is the video for now that I have selected. And as you can see that for humans, it is very easy to see how many people are moving in, say, up direction and down direction. But for a computer, it's exceedingly difficult to check how to do it. So to start with, Raspberry Pi doesn't have much of processing capabilities as far as image is concerned. We wanted to do two things. We wanted to do image processing on Raspberry Pi, and we wanted to make it real time, as real time as possible. So with the current cameras, the problem is they are full resolution HD cameras, and they are like thousands cross thousands in pixels. So the search time for a particular feature increases that many times, like O of n square, as we all might know. So what we did is we have had this theory in running into practical applications. It's called image pyramid. So it's called in the terms of computer vision, it's called either upsampling or downsampling. So you resize the image keeping the aspect ratio the same, constant. That means your feature is saved. That means it does not get aberrated. So we used it to reduce the search time of a particular feature. Now, how do we detect moving objects? Okay. So for example, for instance, there are two frames here. One is called background model and one is called the current frame. When you subtract it, the background gets subtracted totally, and only the objects which are moving or are there in this frame, which are not there in the previous frame, appear. And then you threshold it to get a black and white image. In computer vision, this is called a blob, B-L-O-B. So I'll show you. So the same video. Now, as you can see, we have got blobs here. So these are the blobs which are extracted by pixel differentiation and background subtraction. Now, if I run this video again, as you can see on the left, it's also counting. I'll just move this frame. So what it does is, basically, when the blobs are detected, we try to complete the blob using the external perimeter, and it's called contour detection. And then we fit it with respect to a bounding box around it. And then we try to find the center of the bounding box, and we compare the current frame with the previous frame, and apply a theory called Hungarian algorithm, which is nothing but data association. That means in the current frame, the point associates itself in the next frame, tries to associate itself with the next frame, and the best or the nearest match is selected. But not only that, it can count, it can do other crazy stuff as well. So for example, this, not only it counts, it can, if the camera calibration is right, it can give you the velocity of the objects as well. Now, I mean, one might ask that why do we use it, or what's the application of this? It has got tremendous application in surveillance. So not only this, so we have got a lot of attributes associated with the object. This is a computer vision based solution, remember. But if you integrate TensorFlow with it and you have a classifier or a detector, you can, so for example, if it's a video scene where cars are moving by and you want to count them, not only you can count them, you can also you know, map it to the car make, model, number plate, the license plate, and ID number, timestamp. So if something happens, say, let's say in future, you don't have to go through the entire video. You can just go through the particular event, and you'll get the result. So this is how we did it. These were the attributes that we had generated. Count in, count out, total in, and AHU percentage. So for example, in this room, if the number of people increases, right, the aircon temperature should go down, but it shouldn't, because currently it's set point based, right? So we actually proved using an LED that, you know, when number of people or the crowd density increases, you can actually have an automation protocol linked with it. So that's the AHU. AHU is air handling unit. Yeah, it's a frequent term used in chillers and mechanical components used to control the aircon. So heat maps, we came up with a theory on the spot. And so these are the blobs that are detected, for example. So what we do is we divide the image into n cross n grids. So we reshape the image in a form of square and divide it in n cross n grids. So since it's a black and white image, we know the area of each square. And we divide the number of non-zero pixels, that is white pixels, divided by the total area. And if it's greater than some percent, we give it some color. So whenever the blob moves, depending on how much occupancy it is in each grid, the heat map is made. Okay, user feedback, that was completely automated. So what happens is, currently if you see the subway stations, the MRT stations, so when you move out, there are like few buttons that you have to press, like you are happy or you are sad. But we wanted to do it live and in an automated way. So we used Microsoft Vision API for face recognition. So at a particular spot in the image, whenever the people pass, we take their face readings and just map their emotions directly to the database. That means we don't require anyone to press anything. The face says it all. So for example, if some line is not working, a lot of people would be either angry or upset. So usually it doesn't help, but when something goes wrong, it gives you an idea that yes, something is wrong. So future expansion that we actually demoed, currently I don't have a Wi-Fi, so I cannot connect to the cloud. The thing is, in this method that we have discussed, the blob detection method, even if a dog passes, you know, it is detected as a blob, right? So what we do is, the rectangle that is generated, we pass it through a classifier. And whenever there is a, so we classify it as either as a person, depends on the number of classes. So the training happens as the number of samples increases. So we have got multiple classes like cats, dogs, cars, bikes, humans, like persons. So we just detect a particular object and map it with the attribute. So if we want to count only person, we'll only count the persons. Future expansion is like CNN based object detection scheme. It can be object classification scheme as well. Then, yeah, so one thing why we we came runners up and not won the competition is what they said is the solution had to be end-to-end. It had to have an app. So we couldn't make a web app or a messenger bot. So yeah, integration end-to-end with the web would be the next thing, and that's about it. Thank you. Also, any questions are welcomed, if any.
No. The video from the top, the people are quite dark in the center, because we see, but when you have images which usually have a lot of light, the blobs are not actually very immediately become like a cloud of points. So sometimes in this area, the subtraction is the most simple method.
So in videos like this, subtraction becomes really easy, I agree. But when it's a low end, like low hanging camera, where people appear bigger in size, we usually go for object detection first, followed by tracking. That means detection paradigm would be AI, machine learning based. So for example, the current best performing detectors are YOLO, that is you look only once, which is built on the top of TensorFlow. Any other questions? Okay, thank you.